Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.3, Problem 6. This is Section 5.3, Problem 6. It says, Bart Simpson is going to be receiving a structured settlement of $500 every month for a period of 10 years from Krusty the Clown for an injury that Bart sustained while visiting the Krusty Land House of Knives. Krusty still maintains that those other guests were already decapitated before entering the House of Knives. Krusty's legal advisor said he should invest one lump sum now to pay Bart's settlement. How much does Krusty have to invest now at 9% compounded monthly in order to pay Bart? So the first thing you have to figure out is, what type of question is this? This is present value of an annuity. We're going to essentially be paying a salary. So Bart's going to be getting $500 every month for 10 years. So Krusty's going to pay him 120 payments of $500. That's $60,000 Bart's going to receive. But if Krusty has the money up front, he should be able to pay that with less than $60,000. The interest he earns will help him pay that essentially salary. So it is a present value of an annuity, and the formula for that is A, that lump sum that we're looking for is P, the regular payment, times some fairly big brackets, which has in the numerator of the brackets 1 minus 1 over in parentheses 1 plus R over M, close the parentheses, to the M times T power divided by R over M in the denominator of the brackets. So to fill this out, we have A, the final lump sum, equals P, the regular payment, which for this problem is $500. That's what Bart's going to be getting every month, times the brackets. Now in the brackets, in the numerator, we have 1 minus 1 over, in parentheses, 1 plus R over M. Now the R is the rate as a decimal. So the rate as a decimal for this problem is 9%. Well, as a decimal, it's 0.09. So I'm going to have 0.09 over M. Now M is the number of payments made per year, or the type of compounding, which for this is 12. I'm going to close the parentheses. It has an exponent of M times T. Again, M is 12 for the monthly compounding and monthly payment. T is 10 because it's the number of years. And then in the bottom of the brackets, the denominator of the brackets, R over M again, so 0.09 for the R, for the rate as a decimal, and 12 for the M, the type of compounding and the number of payments per year. So let's start with the work in parentheses, the 1 plus 0.09 over 12. So that will give me A equals 500 times those big brackets, and the numerator of the brackets have 1 minus 1 over in parentheses. 0.09 over 12 is 0.0075, and I'm going to add 1 to it, so it'll be 1.0075. Now again, I do that division pretty easily. If you don't see it easily, just in a few seconds with your calculator, do 0.09 divided by 12 equals, and the calculator will tell you right away it's 0.0075. And don't forget, in the upper part of the brackets, you have to add a 1 to that. So it's 1.0075. It's raised to an exponent, and that exponent is 12 times 10, so the exponent would be 120. Then in the denominator of the brackets, the 0.09 over 12 is going to give you 0.0075. Again, in the denominator of the brackets, you don't have the plus 1 in front of it. Now, I will do the exponent, 1.0075 to the 120th power, and see what I get for that. And then the rest of the formula is going to just get dragged along. So the next step is going to be A equals 500 times the brackets. The numerator of the brackets, I'll have 1 minus 1 over. And then in the denominator of the brackets, I still have 0.0075. So in the top of the brackets, I have 1 minus a fraction. So I want to just write that fraction as a decimal. I have 1 over 2.45135708. I can simplify that again, while the value of 2.45 something's on the screen of my calculator, there's a button that says 1 over x. I'll just press that. So that will be a equals 500 times, in the brackets, the numerator of the brackets, 1 minus 0.4079373305, and in the denominator of the brackets, 0.0075. So the top of the bracket still has a subtraction at 1 minus 0.4079373305. So I'll do that subtraction. And that'll give me A equals 500 times the brackets. The brackets will have in the numerator 0.59206 2695, in the denominator of the brackets 0.0075. And now I'll divide the value in the numerator and denominator of the brackets. So I'm going to have A equals 500 times, and I'm going to divide 0.59206 2695 divided by 0.0075. Will give me one value in the brackets, which is 78.94169267. So I'm going to multiply that times 500. The value I got for the brackets times the 500 in front will give me a final answer of 39470.84633. So now is the time when I want to round off the decimal a little bit. I don't want to eliminate the decimal. I want to have two places after the decimal. So after my decimal, I have 0.846 something. So the 6 is big enough to make it an 85 or 85 cents. So my answer is $39,470.85. Now again, think of what this means. If Krusty the Clown invests this $39,470.85 now, he'll be able to pay Bart $500 a month over a 10-year period. So he's going to pay Bart $60,000 by only having $39,470 available now. So he's going to save a little over $20,000 by having the money up front. The interest that this earns while the $500 a month payments are coming out is what makes up the difference.